Something big is happening right now that most people are missing. China and other major powers are racing to build robot armies, and it's not science fiction anymore. These aren't just fancy tech demos or cool videos online. We're talking about real machines that can think, move, and yes, even fight. By the end of this video, you'll see why China's robot army isn't just coming. It's already here, and it's growing faster than anyone expected. Let's jump right in and break down what's happening, why it matters, and what it means for the future. Trust us. Once you see how all these pieces fit together, you'll never look at global politics the same way again. Think about this. Right now, China is pouring massive amounts of money into robots and AI. Not just for factories or cute home gadgets, but for systems that could completely change how wars are fought. And they're not being quiet about it either. For years, Chinese leaders have been talking openly about winning the AI race. They know that whoever masters this technology first gets a huge advantage, not just economically, but militarily too. It's like when countries race to build nuclear weapons or stealth fighters. Except robots and AI could be even more game-changing. What makes this really scary is how fast everything is moving. Just 5 years ago, military robots were pretty basic, slow, clumsy, and not very smart. Now, Chinese companies are showing off machines that can run across rough ground, identify targets on their own, and work together in large groups without human control. The speed comes down to how China approaches technology development. They've blurred the lines between civilian companies, research labs, and military programs. When a Chinese tech company makes a breakthrough in robot movement or computer vision, that technology can quickly find its way into military systems. They call this civil-military fusion, and it helps them develop new capabilities incredibly fast. We should also mention that China isn't the only player here. The US, Russia, and others are working on similar technology. But China stands out because of how focused they are and how quickly they're moving from ideas to working systems. They're not just talking about robot armies. They're actively building them, testing them, and planning how to use them. This isn't happening in secret either. Chinese military journals openly discuss using robot swarms to overwhelm enemy defenses. State media proudly shows off new drone systems and walking robots. They're betting big on this technology, and they want the world to know it. Let's talk about one of the most impressive parts of China's robot push, their drone program. Chinese companies have become world leaders in making all kinds of drones. From the small ones people fly in parks to massive military systems that can stay in the air for days. What makes China's approach different is their focus on numbers and teamwork. Instead of building a few super advanced, expensive drones like some Western countries, China is creating huge swarms of simpler, cheaper ones that work together. Picture hundreds or even thousands of small drones flying in perfect formation, each one sharing what it sees with all the others. Chinese military exercises have already shown off swarms with dozens of drones moving together like a flock of birds. When one drone spots something important, they can quickly change formation, with some acting as scouts while others move into attack. They can surround targets from all directions, making them almost impossible to defend against. The scary part? Many of these drones can now pick their own targets. They use cameras and AI to tell the difference between, say, a tank and a school bus, or a warship and a fishing boat. They don't need constant human guidance. You can basically point them in a direction and let them hunt for targets on their own. And China isn't keeping this technology to themselves. They've become one of the biggest sellers of military drones worldwide, shipping them to countries across Asia, Africa, and the Middle East. These export models aren't their most advanced systems, of course, but they're giving Chinese companies valuable real-world experience and spreading their influence globally. The numbers coming out of China are mind-blowing. One report mentioned a Chinese company getting orders for components that could support up to 1 million combat drones. Even if that number is exaggerated, even a fraction of that would be more flying robots than any military could easily deal with using current defense systems. Think about what that means in a conflict. Traditional military equipment like tanks, ships, and aircraft are expensive and take years to build. Each one lost is a major setback. But these drones? They're relatively cheap and can be built quickly. China could lose hundreds or thousands and barely feel it. It completely changes the math of warfare. While flying drones get a lot of attention, China's work on walking robots might be even more impressive in the long run. Building machines that can walk and run over rough ground, climb stairs, and use their hands requires solving really hard problems. But China is making huge progress. Chinese company Unitree has unveiled robots that can run at high speeds, keep their balance when pushed, and even do backflips. Another company called KiaiTech showed off robots that can pick up and manipulate objects with surprising skill. These aren't just lab experiments. They're starting to mass produce these machines, planning to make thousands each year. What's helping them move so fast is their approach to teaching these robots. Instead of programming every movement by hand, Chinese researchers use AI simulation. They create virtual worlds where digital robots can practice walking, running, and manipulating objects millions of times, learning from each mistake. When they transfer this learning to real robots, they already have skills that would take forever to program the old way. The military applications are pretty obvious. Robots that can walk anywhere a human can go could be used for dangerous missions like clearing buildings in urban combat, bringing supplies to frontline troops, or even fighting directly. They don't get tired, don't feel fear, and don't need food or sleep. Chinese military writers talk about using these walking robots alongside drone swarms in future conflicts. The drones would provide an aerial view of the battlefield, while ground robots move in to secure territory or attack specific targets. Working together, they could overwhelm defenders from multiple directions at once. And it's not just about combat. China is also using robot development to strengthen its manufacturing base. As their population ages and labor costs rise, robots that can take over factory work help keep their economy competitive. The same technology that powers military robots also helps build consumer goods more cheaply and efficiently. The pace of development is honestly shocking. Each new robot generation shows major improvements in speed, strength, and intelligence. They're getting more energy efficient too, solving one of the biggest problems with earlier models that could only operate for short periods before needing to recharge. So, what does all this mean? We're witnessing the early stages of a revolution in warfare. The days of armies centered around human soldiers may be coming to an end, replaced by mixed forces of humans and machines, or even mostly machines controlled by a few human operators. This has huge implications for global power. Countries that master these technologies gain major advantages. Their armies can fight without risking many human lives. Their factories can produce more goods with fewer workers. They can project power in new ways that traditional militaries struggle to counter. What's particularly worrying is how these robot systems could make conflicts more likely. When leaders don't have to worry about body bags coming home, the political cost of starting a fight drops dramatically. And as robots become more autonomous, decisions about firing weapons might happen too fast for humans to control, potentially leading to rapid escalation. China clearly sees robot and AI development as a path to becoming the world's leading superpower. By investing heavily in these technologies now, they're positioning themselves to have the most advanced systems when they reach maturity. They're playing the long game, building both the hardware and software needed for robot armies while creating the industrial capacity to mass produce them. That doesn't mean conflict is inevitable, but it does mean the balance of power is shifting in ways that could be destabilizing. When new military technologies emerge, there's often a dangerous period before countries figure out how to maintain stability in the new reality. We're entering that period now with military robots and AI. For regular people, this might all seem distant and abstract, but the technologies being developed now will shape our world for decades to come. They'll affect everything from international relations to job markets to basic questions about how wars are fought and who fights them. The robot revolution isn't coming someday in the distant future. It's happening right now, and China is leading the charge. Their robot army isn't science fiction. It's an emerging reality that's growing more capable every day. And whether we're ready or not, it's going to change everything. Thanks for watching. If this video got you thinking, share it with someone who needs to understand what's happening. This is one of those rare moments when technology is fundamentally changing the rules of the game, and staying informed is the first step to navigating the new world that's taking shape. We'll see you in the next video.